Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Juliet Prowse, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, you ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Let's welcome a new player here and our current champion, Martha Shaw, and the newcomer, Chuck Hunter. Okay. How do you feel, Martha? Good.
Now.
Well, let's find out a little. You've calmed down a little bit?
A little.
She's got $5,700, and that made her very happy. Now, let's find out about Chuck Hunter, where he's from, and anything else he wishes to contribute.
Well, Gene, I'm single.
Yeah.
I deal 21 in roulette in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Uh-huh.
And I enjoy racquetball, hunting, fishing, and flying light airplanes and helicopters.
Yes. Well, there's nothing to do in Las Vegas except racquetball and
I don't
flying
gamble.
And hunting and fishing and flying. And flying what?
Light airplanes and helicopters.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Yeah. So you're a fixed wing and a rotary wing pilot.
Yes.
Well, that's quite an accomplishment because it's a quite different technique, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, Chuck, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck, and we'll start this game right after we do a little business with America. Got it? Gotcha. Gotcha. All right, here we go. Chuck, you can have A or B.
B for blank.
B for blank. All right. This is it. The Nerdo Crumbesian army has never won a war.
How come?
I'll tell you, they're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do is blank.
They're such bad fighters?
They're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do is blank. That's why they've never won a war.
I think I got this one.
Don't look.
Nerdo Crumbesia is our mythical country.
Yeah, oh, yes.
They've never won a war. They're such bad fighters. All they're trained to do is blank. These are military epaulettes you're wearing. Are you a member of the Nerdo Crumbesian army?
I've been with them now 4 years.
You have? And you've never won a
never
war?
Never won a war.
What countries have you fought?
Let me think without getting into trouble. Poland beat us. Did that give you a clue?
Yes, I got you. All right, thank you very much, General. Now we come over here to Chuck Hunter. The Nerdo Crumbesian army has never won a war, Chuck. They're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do is...
make love.
Yeah. Make love?
That's all came to my mind.
Really? What do you say to this?
Well, it's a terrific idea.
I'd make you lose the war, I suppose.
No, but. I put retreat.
Retreat, yeah. See, you don't have to train to make love, Chuck. As a single man, you ought to know that.
Doing what comes naturally.
Right. You don't have to be trained to do that, do you?
You and I know that, don't
yeah,
we?
Yeah. Cut.
I think he's the man who told me to leave the 21 table when I started adding on my fingers.
Uh-huh.
True. I said retreat. I'm sorry. I mean,
retreat is, seems to be the definitive answer so far, Charles.
I said march in pretty formation.
March in pretty formation. They're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do, Juliet, is...
give up.
Give up. Yeah, that's good. Give up, retreat, all those things. Excellent.
We're both single, Chuck, and you should know that you do not train to make love. Doesn't hurt to practice, but you shouldn't have to train. El Surrendo.
Surrender. Seems to be the one. And Patti Deutsch.
Hi.
Hi. Are you going to be a nonconformist?
Oh, I don't... huh?
I don't know.
No, I said hem their own pants.
Hem their own pants.
That is what we have to do.
I suppose that would interfere with...
yeah, we do that.
Yes, all right, okay. All right, now, Martha, let's see what we've got for you here. The owner of the baseball team hates people. And that's why at the last game he hired blank to sing the national anthem. The owner of the baseball team
hates people.
That's why, at the last game, he hired Blank to sing the national anthem.
No kidding.
I don't put them in there.
You do it like this.
That's the way I do it. Then how do you pull it out?
Within a game.
No.
All right, Martha. Charles is just finishing up his answer. I'll read it while he's finishing. The owner of the baseball team hates people, and that's why at the last game, he hired Blank to sing the national anthem.
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. Good answer. You'd get your blood boiling if you hate people.
I met Howard last week. He was very pleasant.
Really? I met him once. He was very unpleasant.
Well, there you go.
That's 1-1. Anyone else care to make a contribution?
No. I put down, avoiding humans singing it, I put down Lassie.
Lassie. You've got your dog upside down, David.
See, it's wrong. I told you it was wrong.
If you leave him alone, you're getting them all mixed up.
I'm trying to help him because he's my friend.
This kind of friends you don't need, David.
No, it's wrong.
No, Howard Cosell?
It was all done because for the people who want to chase the national anthem because you have to go to, I was like, can you see by the dancer, Howard Cosell?
I see. All right. That's one for Martha. You thought this through very carefully, didn't you? I like your new glasses.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you like my new hair. Howard Cosell.
Cosello. Right. Two for Martha. The last game he hired Howard Cosell to sing the national anthem, according to her.
Well.
What did he say, according to you?
When you got children, you watch Sesame Street a lot.
Big
said,
Bird.
Big Bird.
Big Bird. Well, she was going for an animal of some kind. That's implied in the question there. What'd
Being
you say?
A music lover, I was going to say Eddie Fisher. Anytime. Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. You're sad and lonely.
Thank you.
Anytime. Nice. What do you say?
Nixon.
All right, so there we are at the end of round one. 3-0 score favorite Martha Shaw, the current champ. Now we got this message just for you. Okay, here we go to round two. This is the final round, and Chuck, again, you have a choice of A or B.
I'm going to stay with B.
All right. Everyone plays. All right. Arnie the Angel was thrown out of heaven for using his halo as a blank.
Now, does his name have anything to do with this question?
No.
Arnie the Angel. I'm a very quick study. Arnie the Angel was thrown out of heaven for using his blank as a
halo. His halo as a blank. For using his halo as a blank.
Yes, I know it, John. You're so cute. You can only do one answer, sweetheart.
Yeah, one answer to a customer is all we allowed.
What are we going to do with it?
I got it.
All right. All right, Chuck, have you thought of over? Here it is. Arnie the Angel was thrown out of heaven for using his halo as a...
I don't know if angels do it, but I said toity.
Your championship is secure. All right. What do you say, David?
Well, I think this is very close. It's part of it, or possibly it could be all of it. I said a little potty seat.
Potty seat. There's one. I thought he was going to strike out with that completely. And this weirdo matched him.
Weirdo.
What do you say?
The Cincinnati kid over there, right? Dealing them in Las Vegas and saying tidy seats in Los Angeles. I said frisbee.
Frisbee. Listen to your people, Chuck.
They're too late.
Yeah. What do you say?
Frisbee
it is. First. All right, Chuck, it's 3-1 now. Juliet?
Well, Chuck, I had Tweety and I threw it away and I put up frisbee.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Okay, now you must match the two remaining ones, Chuck, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. He's looking for, and he doesn't get it. That means Martha wins the game. All right. There you go, right to your place there. Chuck, it was a pleasure to meet you.
It was fun being here, Gene.
We'll send some gifts your way, and thank you for playing Match Game 77.
Thank you.
Chuck Hunter, ladies and gentlemen, there you go. Okay, Martha. There it is, all for you, my dear. You could win another $5,000, maybe $5,500 here, whatever, $2,500, another $1,000. Let's begin now. Not too long ago, we polled a bunch in this studio, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank pop-up. If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100. And whom do you call on over here?
Charles.
Mama and Papa.
Mama and Papa is one.
Brett.
What was that song that they...
Oh, My Papa? Was
that... No, it's not it.
Eddie Grant. Fisher's big hit. Sing Oh, My Papa.
Oh, My Papa. That's it. That's all I'm going
to
say.
To me, he was so wonderful. Oh, My Papa. Oh, my yes, papa. Just like, yeah, right. There you go.
And Patti.
Patti, you're the one. Patti Deutsch.
Yeah.
Your name
I
is Deutsch,
her.
Right.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Right.
Grand.
Grandpapa, okay?
No, Grand Ball.
Grandpapa, Oh, My Papa, and Mama and Papa are the three that the celebrities have given you. Now, you can reject all those and give us one of your own. You may have a better idea, Martha.
I'm going to go with Oh, My Papa.
The song. Okay. It's Brett's answer. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response. Grandpapa. There's Patty's answer. May we see the $250 number. Mama and Papa. I thought Mama and Papa was going to be up on top there. All right, here's the last chance for you, my dear. Slide it, please. You got it! Atta girl!
Oh, mine.
Is that the way it is?
M-I-N-E.
The song,
that's actually,
Richard's pointing out.
That is good news and bad news. That's good news for you. The bad news is Eddie Fisher could be making a comeback.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, mine, Papa.
Is it Oh, Mine, Papa?
Yeah.
The way he sang it?
Yeah.
I never could
it's
understand.
It's a German
him.
Song.
All right. Now, Martha, you've won another $500. You have $6,300 as a total now. And again, you're going to play for $5,000. And to collect, you've got to match one celebrity.
I've got to go with Richard because I always match with him on television.
Okay, that's your choice. It's up to you. Swing around here a little
What's
bit,
this?
And we're all set to go here. Good luck to you, Martha. It's worth $5,000, and it reads as follows. Best of blank. Okay, Martha, give us the answer that Richard has written on the card. We give you another $5,000.
Something I need, luck.
Best of luck. All right. Best of everything for you.
Oh.
Oh. She says luck will match you.
Well, I thought we were the best of...
Friends. Oh, yeah, that's a good
one. With a little bit of...
Very good, Martha. You now have $11,300. Martha's very happy lady here, $11,300. Shall we welcome your new competitor now, Martha? Shall we do that? Okay, here comes Charlene Hartenstein. Martha Shaw's a very happy lady, Charlene.
I don't blame her.
I don't blame her either.
Now, I knew you were going to say Hartenstein.
Why? Is
well,
it Hartenstein?
If you ask my junior high school students, they'd tell you it rhymes with Frankenstein.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Or Leonard Bernstein?
Yes.
Frankenstein. Charlene Hartenstein. Yeah. Why do some say Steen and some say Stein?
I don't know. Who knows?
You don't know?
No.
Where are you from, Charlene?
Irvine, California.
All right!
I'm a junior high school teacher, and I'm married to a medical student.
Uh-huh.
And this is my lucky day because we have three redheads on the game today.
Three redheads?
Three redheads. There's
That's
two
right.
and me.
Juliet, Patti, and Charles. No. All right, Charlene, we'll get this thing off the ground and get it going here right after we do a little business with America. Don't go away now. Danny Olson. Now, Charlene, if you're ready, we'll ask you to make a decision here about A or B.
A.
A it is. The natural redhead has chosen A. Fred dropped his TV set on the floor.
What about the other three?
What about
that him? That was very snotty.
What?
The natural redhead has chosen me.
Natural redhead.
What about the three of us? You were saying that we were not natural.
No. I know she's natural because I can see her roots.
Those roots every time.
Yes.
She's natural. Oh,
she's God. Natural.
I'm not.
You're not?
Well, she got her hair dyed. I didn't want to give your secret away.
I think you're beautiful. Same color hair as hers, isn't it?
Close.
One out of a bottle and one out of a... Anyway.
Oh, you're going to get it worse.
You're in the most awful trouble now.
Fred dropped his... Let's just press on now. Don't divert me. Fred dropped his TV set on the floor, and when he picked it up, it was still working. But the CBS eye was blank. He dropped his TV set on the floor. It was still working, but the CBS eye was blank. And, very good.
Isn't that a cute answer,
yes,
huh?
Darling.
I like it.
Okay, Charlene, I'll give it to you one more time while they're finishing up writing here. Fred dropped his TV set on the floor. When he picked it up, it was still working, but the CBS eye was blank.
Blind?
That's all right, that's good.
Well?
We'll see.
That's her answer.
Blind.
Yes.
Which means that unable to see, right?
Correct.
Right. Well, now, that would be the same predicament if it were shut.
If it were shut.
No.
The judge says it's different. What do you say?
I say it's all black and blue. And
black
blue.
And blue?
Thank you very much.
Charles?
With all the clothes?
Yes.
Red, bloodshot, definitely real red, naturally red, red, black blood, red, red, red.
Charles, he's the only one who does 9 minutes when you ask him for a simple one-word answer there. What do you say, Juliet?
Well, I said it was cross-eyed.
Cross-eyed? What was that? Oh, dear me. Well, what do you say to this?
Bloodshot.
Bloodshot eye. And Patti Deutsch.
Was wearing a cold compress.
Was wearing a cold compress. Well, if black and blue had been her answer, that might have matched because you only wear a cold compress for black and blue. All right, Martha Shaw. Ugly Edna is so ugly. Only woman in the world that uses blank remover on her face. Only woman in the world who uses blank remover on her face.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Got it all done up
right
there, babe.
All right. Right there.
Oh, it's terrible.
Okay. Now we're rolling along here, Martha. Ugly Edna is so ugly, Martha. She's the only woman in the world that uses blank remover on her face.
Fingernail polish.
Fingernail polish? Fingernail polish remover, she said, David.
What has she got up there?
What is this, the Dick Martin Award?
This is the Dick Martin Award answer.
Yeah.
Oh, I should never show you anything.
Right.
Well, I put it down. Now you've got me so embarrassed. I thought
no, there's nothing to be embarrassed about.
With skin remover.
Yes. Skin remover.
He did it wrong. You told him. Didn't I tell you I told him? I told you I told
Stop
him.
It.
Now leave him alone. Show us your answer.
I said paint remover.
Very good. Okay, Charles.
Spot remover.
Spot remover. Martha's looking for a fingernail polish remover, Juliet.
Nail polish remover.
Well, she's got one. Richard?
Paint.
Paint remover is the definitive answer. And you, Patti?
Floor wax.
Floor wax remover. Okay, 1-0 in favor of Martha Shaw. Now this, just for you. All right, Charlene and Martha, we've got to stop the game right here, but we'll look forward to seeing you, both of you, next time. Now, what's that? Oh, yeah.
Huh? What? Huh?
Is there something that we could plug for you that
well,
we should have said?
Well, not for me, but my husband, John McCook, who plays Lance Prentice on The Young and the Restless.
Yes.
They have a special this week, a musical special.
Here on CBS?
It's here on CBS, daytime.
Well, how wonderful.
Yep.
Yeah, well, with all those daytime stars.
Yeah.
They did that once before, and it was very good.
Yeah.
Splendid. All right. And don't forget to look for what's his name there on Charlie's Angels.
What's his name?
And we'll look forward to seeing you next time. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game. Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Juliet Prowse, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
John, you ready? Ain't ready?
Good.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Let's welcome a new player here and our current champion, Martha Shaw, and the newcomer, Chuck Hunter. Okay. How do you feel, Martha? Good.
Now.
Well, let's find out a little. You calmed down a little bit?
A little.
She's got $5,700, and that made her very happy. Now, let's find out about Chuck Hunter, where he's from, and anything else he wishes to contribute.
Well, Gene, I'm single.
Yeah.
I deal 21 in roulette in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Uh-huh.
And I enjoy racquetball, hunting, fishing, and flying light airplanes and helicopters.
Yes. Well, there's nothing to do in Las Vegas except racquetball and
I don't
flying
gamble.
And hunting and fishing and flying. And flying what?
Light airplanes and helicopters.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Yeah. So you're a fixed wing and a rotary wing pilot.
Yes.
Well, that's quite an accomplishment because it's a quite different technique, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, Chuck, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck, and we'll start this game.
I'd
make
you
lose the war, I suppose.
No, I put retreat.
Retreat, yeah. See, you don't have to train to make love, Chuck. As a single man, you ought to know that.
You're doing what comes naturally.
Right. You don't have to be trained to do that, do you?
You and I know that, don't
yeah,
we?
Yeah. Cut.
I think he's the man who told me to leave the 21 table when I started adding on my fingers.
Uh-huh.
True. I said retreat. I'm sorry.
Retreat seems to be the definitive answer so far, Charles.
I said march in pretty formation.
March in pretty formation. They're such bad fighters. All they're trained to do, Juliet, is...
Give up.
Give up. Yeah, that's good. Give up, retreat, all those things. Excellent.
We're both single, Chuck, and you should know that you do not train to make love. Doesn't hurt to practice, but you shouldn't have to train. El Surrendo.
Surrender. Seems to be the one. And Patti Deutsch.
Hi.
Hi. Are you going to be a nonconformist?
Oh, I don't... Huh?
I don't know.
No, I said hem their own pants.
Hem their own pants.
That is what we have to do.
I suppose that would interfere with...
Yeah, we do that.
Yes, all right, okay. All right, now, Martha, let's see what we've got for you here. The owner of the baseball team hates people. And that's why at the last game he hired blank to sing the national anthem. The owner of the baseball team
hates people.
That's why at the last... game, he hired blank to sing the national anthem.
No kidding.
I don't put him in there.
You do it like this.
That's the way I do it. How do you pull it out?
So game within a game, within a game, within a game.
No.
All right, Martha. Charles is just finishing up his answer. I'll read it while he's finishing. The owner of the baseball team hates people, and that's why at the last game, he hired blank to sing the national anthem.
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. Good answer. You get your blood boiling if you hate people.
I met Howard last week. He seemed, it was very pleasant.
Really? I met him once. He was very unpleasant.
Well, there you go.
That's 1-1. Anyone else care to make a contribution?
No. I put down, avoiding humans singing it, I put down Lassie.
Lassie. You've got your dog upside down, David.
See, it's wrong. I told you it was wrong.
If you leave him alone, you're getting them all mixed up.
I'm trying to help him because he's my friend.
This kind of friends you don't need, David.
No, it's wrong.
No, Howard Cosell?
Yeah, it was all done because for the people who want to change the national anthem because you have to go to, I was thinking, you see about the dancer, Howard Cosell.
I see. Right after we do a little business with America. Thought I got you. Gotcha. All right, here we go. Chuck, you can have A or B.
B for blank.
B for blank. All right. This is it. The Nerdo Crumbesian army has never won a war.
How come?
I'll tell you, they're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do is blank.
They're such bad fighters?
They're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do is blank. That's why they've never won a war.
I think I got this one.
Don't look.
Nerdo Crumbesia is our mythical country.
Yeah, oh, yes.
They've never won a war. They're such bad fighters. All they're trained to do is blank. These are military epaulettes you're wearing. Are you a member of the Nerdo Crumbesian army?
I've been with them now 4 years.
You have? And you've never won a war?
Never won a war.
What countries have you fought?
Let me think without getting into trouble. Poland beat us. Does that give you a clue?
Yes, I got you. All right, thank you very much, General. Now we come over here to Chuck Hunter. The Nerdo Crumbesium Army has never won a war, Chuck. They're such bad fighters, all they're trained to do is...
make love.
Yeah. Make love?
That's all came to my mind.
Really? What do you say to this?
Well, it's a terrific idea.
All right, that's one for Martha. You thought this through very carefully, didn't you? I like your new glasses.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you like my new hair. Howard Cosell.
Cosello. Right. Two for Martha. The last game, he hired Howard Cosell to sing the national anthem, according to her.
Well.
What did he say, according to you?
When you got children, you watch Sesame Street a lot.
Big
I said,
Bird.
Big Bird.
Big Bird.
Yeah.
Well, she was going for an animal of some kind. That's implied in the question there. What
Being
you say?
A music lover, I was going to say Eddie Fisher. Anytime. Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. You're sad and lonely.
Thank you.
Anytime. Nice. What do you say?
Nixon.
Nixon. All right, so there we are at the end of round one. 3-0 score favorite Martha Shaw, the current champ. Now we got this message just for you. Okay, here we go to round two. This is the final round, and Chuck, again, you have a choice of A or B.
I'm going
to
stay with B.
All right. Everyone plays.
All right.
Arnie the Angel was thrown out of heaven for using his halo as a blank.
Now, does his name have anything to do with this question?
No.
Arnie?
Arnie.
Oh, Arnie. Arnie the Angel was thrown, a very quick study. Arnie the Angel was thrown out of heaven for using his blank as a halo.
His halo as a blank.
Yeah.
For using his halo as a blank.